this picture in the show.
Okay, let's keep going here. Now I gotta find out which step. I got more of these sweet biased, that is on the bias, diagonally cut. That's right, I just used that word. Pieces, let's see. All right, so it looks like step one is gonna be to put these three pieces together. So I need this, I'm gonna need two of this phalange. Oh, that's another great one. Phoebe and her use of the word phalange. So this goes like this. Get this. And then this gets stuck onto our swiveler. Right here. Let me see. Bingo. Just like that. Boom chicka. Boom chicka pop. These guys similarly get stuck like that. Make sure I do this without breaking Legos. That arm all the way. Yeah, looks like it. Cool. Next step. Oh, fuck yeah. Building more layers. Now, we need the gray phalanges. This big phalange goes. So I need the other direction. That's, I love these. So, like, they're actually different pieces. They could just well be the same, but the dots are arranged in different ways, so you have to be really careful. My word to the wise, probably the smartest thing I'm going to say all day, is you have two different phalange shapes. Make millions off of that. Keep going. Is that big enough? Yeah, that's a tensor. Yeah, so I always wonder why they do this. Like, why do you have a threeser, a tensor, and a threeser instead of two fivesers and a sixer? I mean, there's obviously some reason, but then again, you're just making a row of dots. Like, how big a difference does it really make? I already put that one down. Can I put down that? Okay, now I need a gold twoser. This guy's gonna go here. Yep. This special, smaller, mini diagonal flange. And then we need another diagonal flange. Just gonna go here. I think you can see that. If you can't, I'm sorry. I'm a new film producer. All right, on to page 42. Nice, I read 42 pages today. Another Joey line. I get enough of that from books. Books, all right, comic books, cereal boxes, but it's enough. Oh man, this is gonna get complicated now, so bear with me. So we need a big flat, and then we're gonna take a forzer. Forzer's gonna sit like this. And then Jonathan White. Here. It's twosers. One twoser like that. Get another twoser like that. See this thing? This is like a little hook right on there. Gotta love Lego. It's so complex. It's beautiful. It's a beautiful system. Only the world works this way. Getting a little nervous about the primaries. I know I'm supposed to be talking about Friends probably as I do this, but that's another thing. Friends actually really, like, Friends really avoids politics, which is maybe why so many people like it. But, like, they never talk about a city council election. They never talk about the New York City mayor. It's like they don't even live in New York. So that really amazes me. Now that I say it, I'm kind of stunned. again, there's no mention of who would be mayor at that time. Not Giuliani. Well, actually, yeah, at the very end, Giuliani. Then the other guy, whose name I can't pronounce, Ed Koch, Koch, Mayor Koch. We'll call him Koch. I'm going to say it's Koch because I know Koch is the Koch brothers. Oh, I got to build another one of these. So exciting. I need another gray Forzer. There it is. I swear, after that first like bag one, bag two moment, now I'm paranoid that I'm missing parts. But yeah, they don't talk about friends. There's no like, there's no representative. There's they don't. Jesus, they don't even talk about the Bill Clinton's impeachment, and it was running. What's the right word? Coterminously, contemporaneous. I feel really stupid that I don't know which of those to use. They were running concurrently at the same time. But yeah, like there's no, you know, talk about impeachment. I would assume that all the friends are liberals, but I guess you don't know. I mean, Joey's Italian. His parents could be pretty conservative, like religiously. They're very Catholic, so they would probably be anti-abortion. But that's like another thing that they never broach. Now this is gonna get crazy. So here we are. I need a little Forzer that's gonna sit right here. Let's get that Forzer in there. Then there's a tall boy. This fatty. It's gonna sit like that. Then over the lights, we have this guy, a little gray tan. That reminds me of the desert Legos, when there was like exploring and it was subtly racist because it was colonial Legos. Oh, now we're using the greens. Greens. Hey, Rachel Green. Fat bricks. Yeah. I think this is like probably one of the more popular Lego shapes. Just because like you can chew on it if you're a little kid. But it's also really great as a structural asset in the Legos you're building. You can pretty quickly elevate your Lego. Oh man, their onesers. These are the best. These little guys. Just like the simplest brick you can think of. It's like, this is like the equivalent of prime factorization. How many which Lego bricks are prime bricks, and you can factor those or not factor them and make little mini prime number Legos by doing a factor tree. So this gets stuck on here like this. I'm gonna try to cue you into a little more action. I feel like I've been ignoring that part of this video. Again, forgive me, I'm new. So now we have this sweet little rotate. I don't know if you can see that because of the glare. Let's see, I'm gonna do this little rotate symbol. So it looks like I gotta turn the Lego now so that it's facing this way. Yep. Need my last big phalange of this bag. And this is gonna go here. Now I need a gold longy. This goes almost to the end. Need a little space. Need a gray long boy. That's gonna fit like that. Yep. I'm going to use my little ticker parter here, which I see now comes with this guy for the, I forget what kind of Lego that's called. You just saw me rub my nose. How lovely. It's going to be a germed Lego. Deal with it. I need another light. go here. I like that this is more than 1,000 pieces, too. It's kind of like a puzzle in that sense. Like, you know how if you get, like, a 200-piece puzzle and you're done in 20 minutes? This Lego actually requires some thinking power. And patience. Now we're going to be using these jagged fellows. Last time I saw this Lego was the Lego castle, which is probably still at my parents' house. But I need this first. And then I'm going to build onto this. What would this be? It's not quite a trapezoid. It's a Star Wars fleet commander ship. No, it looks like a stealth bomber. That's what it is. God, you gotta love our world. Shapes that we associate with, things that we associate with shapes or tools of violence. What the fucking world. This place is falling apart. Burn and die. Anyway. Get this, like that. I need another tall boy, but I think it's one without a little dot. There. And, oh, cool. Okay, so there's this little, like, triangle piece. I don't know if you can see that. That is just going to sit like that. Nice. That's the kicker right there. And then this baby plops on right there. Cool. All right. Let's keep rolling. I like where this is going. Now we get to use this big red boy. Red is going to go here, and we get to use a little L brick. That's what I would call this, the L, like that. I wonder how you get a job at Lego. Not like the Lego theme park, like the one that's over in, East Boston, Somerville, but like a Lego designer. You probably have to be like Harrison. Shit! Like someone whose name, who's someone who's not related to me, but who's really smart and cool, and who may have gotten me this Lego. Anyway, yeah. On to new step. You can see, so, like, bag one of Legos is fast diminishing. So I'm going to need to re-up here, recaffeinate, not with actual coffee, but with more Legos. Okay, there's that, perfect, fat brick here, and a little tweezer, that baby's gonna sit like that, need another curved guy, or not curved, but a little sloper, it's gonna sit just like that. Now we need another L. It's going to pop on just like that. And then this baby goes... How do I fit this on? This goes like that. Oh, this is so cool. Greatest present ever. Okay. All right. We're in business. Assembling more green pieces. I like the green. It's a great color. Whoever designed this, whoever made this Lego color, whatever mix of Roy G. Biv's. I guess if it's green, it's what? Just blue and yellow. So, whoever made this mix of Yibs. Like that. And, yeah, I'm really trying hard not to talk about politics right now, but Massachusetts primary, I just gave away where I lived, is less than 2 months away. Iowa's just around the corner. I'm really freaking out because I don't know if Bernie Sanders is gonna. I really don't know if he wins. Like I'll vote for whoever wins. I bet you Trump doesn't even know what a Lego is. And that's not only why I'll vote, but I'm nervous that Bernie will be able to unite any sort of coalition that can really excite people. I'm really scared. I'm a guy, and I'm a white male. Jared Kushner's Jewish, so I even have that going for me because I'm Jewish too. Although he's a snake, so you can't really be too sure because he could always sell us out, as he already has in the Middle East, by advocating for corrupt people who don't really care about minorities. I'm not actually a minority, so I'm not saying that I'm a victim or anything. It's troubling. Make sure I did this right here. So I have a wonder. Okay, so yeah, so this needs to make up particular partners. Maybe. There we go. So this piece not to go there. This goes here. I don't know how I caught that, but I'm glad that I did. And then there's that little tweezer. Just gonna go over here. Boom. Turn the page. Page 52. God, I'm just cranking through this book. It's a good read. Now, over here we go. Plop. Boom. But yeah, like, again, if I don't. I think I'm probably going to vote for a woman in the primary. I really do think that a woman can win, but I think all our speculation about can a woman win is just a really self-defeating prophecy by saying, like, oh, I don't think a woman can win. So then, yeah, no, obviously she's not going to win. If enough people start saying that, then enough people are going to start believing it. And then where are you left? You're screwed. Okay. Keep going. Boom. Now I need a flatter. So this flat goes there. This guy goes here. This guy with two schniggers sticking up is there. Here. This fits in like that. Look at that. Look at that. Beautiful. Sometimes I wonder if my neighbors are listening to me right now. Probably not. They have better things to do. Actually, not that worried. This fits like that. So we're making like this really cool smooth surface here that things are probably going to slide along. My other anxiety is that, like, people are gonna elect Joe Biden because they think that he's the best candidate, but it's kind of like the opposite of the self-fulfilling prophecy of the women. Like if you think Joe Biden's gonna be the best candidate, then yeah, a lot of people are gonna think that, even though there's not actually gonna be that really close vetting of him. We're not really thinking this through. So I have some leftover pieces right now. So I want to make sure that I didn't miss anything. I'm going to hold off on pondering politics for just a second. Yeah, no, I wasn't supposed to use any of those. I guess those are just extras. So I'm going to put those in my little bowl here. Onesie. I guess if this thing falls apart, you will know why. So, bag one, the base. No, not Dingus and Chief's base, but Lego base. All right, so we're going to take a pause there because I need to go to the bathroom. Thank you for watching.